For centuries, we've tiptoed around the concept of black holes, often questioning whether they're merely theoretical constructs or actual celestial entities. However, our fascination turned to awe when we made the astonishing discovery that these mysterious cosmic chasms, formed from the remnants of massive dying stars, not only exist, but also have an extraordinary level of power. The gravitational forces are so immensely strong that they warp both space and time, relentlessly capturing and devouring everything in their path, including light itself. Now, in a shocking turn of events, a terrifyingly dormant black hole has been discovered lurking dangerously close to our solar system, sending shivers down the spines of scientists. Why has it remained unidentified until now, and does its closeness to our solar system pose a threat? Join us as we unravel the origins of this dormant black hole, explore why it didn't result from a supernova, and discover the potential threat it poses to Earth. To begin this journey, let's start with a quick story. Back in 1975, two brilliant physicists, Stephen Hawking and Kip Thorne, made a fascinating bet. The subject of their wager was the mysterious object known as Cygnus X1, a captivating celestial entity emitting intense X-rays. This friendly bet became the buzz of the scientific community at the time, as it wasn't every day you see two intellectual powerhouses engaged in a friendly wager. So here's what the bet was about. Thorne was convinced that Cygnus X1 could be a black hole, while Hawking bet against him, hoping to be proven wrong. Hawking proposed the terms. If his theory of Cygnus X1 not being a black hole turned out to be correct, Thorne would have to admit defeat and get a subscription to Private Eye, a fancy magazine. But if Hawking was wrong, he'd have to cough up a 4-year subscription to Penthouse for Thorne. Time passed, and the scientific community was on the edge of their seats, eagerly awaiting the outcome of the bet. Scientists intensively studied Cygnus X1 to unravel its true nature. Enhanced images from the Chandra X-ray Observatory provided clear insights into the object's high-energy emissions. However, it wasn't until the early 1990s that a breakthrough occurred, leading to Hawking's defeat. The mounting evidence strongly supported the notion that Cygnus X1 was indeed a black hole, the first ever confirmed. Hawking was actually quite happy with the result of the bet, even though he lost that bet to Kip Thorne from the California Institute of Technology. He saw it as some sort of public validation for all the hard work he and his colleagues put into studying black holes. He said, "I've done a lot of work on black holes, and it would all be wasted if it turned out that black holes do not exist." Keep watching as we are about to explore something Stephen Hawking couldn't have predicted at the time. Something that puts a dent in our current model of what celestial bodies exist in space and how most terrifying entities are hiding in plain sight just a few light years away from our solar system. But before we dive into all these strange details of this monstrous black hole, let's provide you with some important context. Black holes are some of the most fascinating and mysterious objects in our universe. They have a powerful gravitational force that prevents even light, the fastest entity known to us, from escaping. These entities are not truly holes. Rather, they're huge concentrations of matter condensed within incredibly tiny spaces. The boundary of a black hole, known as the event horizon, is a point of no return beyond which we cannot see or observe anything that enters. Anything that crosses the event horizon collapses into the singularity of the black hole, an infinitely small and dense point where the laws of physics and space-time cease to exist. There are two main types of black holes that scientists have theorized: stellar black holes and supermassive black holes. Stellar black holes form when massive stars die and collapse. These typically have a mass that ranges from 10 to 50 times that of our Sun and are scattered throughout the universe. It's possible that there are millions of these stellar black holes in our own Milky Way galaxy. On the other hand, supermassive black holes are much larger, with masses millions or even billions of times greater than our Sun. Although scientists are unsure about their formation, we do know that supermassive black holes exist at the centers of large galaxies, including our own. For example, the supermassive black hole Sagittarius A at the center of the Milky Way has a mass roughly equal to 4 million suns, and a diameter comparable to the distance between the Earth and our Sun. Because black holes are invisible, scientists rely on observing their effects on surrounding matter to detect and study them. They study phenomena such as accretion disks, which form when gases and dust are pulled towards a black hole, and quasars, which are powerful jets of particles emitted by supermassive black holes. These observations provide valuable insights into the nature and behavior of black holes, despite their elusive and mysterious nature. Before we delve into the recently discovered dormant black hole, let's begin by exploring one of the most extensively studied black holes. It's none other than Cygnus X1, as mentioned earlier. It's famously associated with Stephen Hawking and Kip Thorne's bet. Hang on a sec, guys, before we continue, be sure to join the Insane Curiosity channel. Click on the bell, you'll help us to make products of even higher quality. What does Cygnus X1 tell us about the newly discovered black hole? Cygnus X1 resides approximately 6,070 light-years away from Earth, and astronomers have measured this distance using the parallax trigonometry method. In 1964, American radio astronomer Charles Thomas Bolton identified a powerful radio source in the Cygnus constellation, which was later named Cygnus X1. Renowned scientist Stephen Hawking, along with Robert Oppenheimer and Hartland Snyder, proposed in 1971 that Cygnus X1 might be a black hole formed from a supernova explosion. They observed that Cygnus X1 is a binary star system consisting of massive stars and invisible objects with immense masses that generate strong gravitational forces. Today we know that Cygnus X1 has a mass of approximately 21.2 times that of our Sun, and can only be a black hole resulting from the collapse of a larger star. This black hole was likely formed around 5 million years ago when a star roughly 40 times the mass of the Sun collapsed without undergoing a supernova. The reason we suspect it didn't undergo a supernova is because it seemed to be consistently positioned in the same location as black holes that undergo a supernova shift. Supernovas rarely result in a perfect outcome. They typically give black holes a slight kick. The discovery of Cygnus X1 marked the birth of X-ray astronomy and the confirmation of the first ever black hole. The formation of Cygnus X1's black hole occurred through the evolutionary process of a massive star. When a very massive star exhausts its fuel, the remaining stellar core collapses under the intense force of gravity, resulting in a singularity, a point of infinite density at the center of the black hole. Cygnus X1's black hole has an estimated mass of 15 to 20 times that of the Sun. One distinctive feature of the Cygnus X1 black hole is its existence in a binary system. This system comprises a dominant black hole and a smaller companion star. The companion star, likely an active massive star, has a mass of approximately 15 times that of the Sun and a radius about 20 times that of the Sun. These binary companions orbit each other at a distance of around 0.2 astronomical units with an orbital period of about 5.6 days. The companion star orbits the black hole due to its close proximity and the gravitational pull exerted by the black hole. An intriguing phenomenon associated with the Cygnus X1 black hole is the presence of an accretion disk. As the companion star approaches the black hole, matter from the star falls into the black hole through a hot disk surrounding it. The material within this accretion disk becomes extremely heated due to the interplay of gravity and friction, generating a substantial amount of energy, including intense X-ray radiation. The X-ray radiation emitted from the black hole, Cygnus X1, originates from an accretion disk surrounding the black hole. Matter falling into the black hole converts gravitational potential energy into kinetic energy and heat. The high temperature within the accretion disk leads to the emission of intense X-ray radiation. This radiation arises from matter heated to temperatures in the millions of degrees Celsius, producing X-ray photons. Now we'll move our attention to the Milky Way, where a new fascinating discovery has been made: a huge black hole that lurks too close to Earth. What is this dominant black hole found near our solar system? To everyone's surprise, a new and unusual discovery has emerged directly from the data collected by the Gaia telescope. Thanks to the unmatched precision of the Gaia Space Observatory, which belongs to the European Space Agency, the astronomers from the Gaia collaboration have unveiled an exceptional stellar system hidden within the constellation Aquila. This unique system resides at a distance of 590 parsecs, which is nearly 2,000 light years away. During the validation process, Gaia's telescopes initially detected a solitary aged giant star at that specific position in the sky. However, after meticulously analyzing over 5.5 years of Gaia's observations, a remarkable revelation has surfaced. The motion displayed by this seemingly lone star deviates significantly from what was anticipated for a single star. This strongly indicates the presence of a massive, invisible companion with a mass almost 50 times greater than the star originally observed by Gaia. The most plausible explanation for this companion is a black hole that was formed billions of years ago through the collapse of an enormous star. Its extraordinary mass, 33 times that of the Sun, makes it the most massive black hole of stellar origin discovered within our galaxy. Until now, such high-mass black holes were solely observed in distant galaxies through gravitational wave telescopes. Both the star and the black hole orbit a shared center of mass, which is denoted by the green cross. The discovery of Gaia BH3 introduces the third binary system housing a black hole identified by the Gaia Collaboration. However, what sets this system apart is its exceptionally high mass and significantly wider orbit. The giant star in the system completes a full orbit around the black hole approximately every 11.6 years. At their farthest point from each other, they are separated by nearly 29 astronomical units, a distance comparable to that between the Sun and Neptune. During their closest approach, the distance narrows to approximately 4.5 astronomical units, akin to the distance between the Sun and Jupiter. The orbit of the black hole itself is comparable to the size of Mercury's orbit around the Sun. Another intriguing aspect of this star is its chemical composition, characterized by an abundance of hydrogen and helium, but a scarcity of heavier elements. This suggests that the precursor star of this high-mass black hole companion also lacked heavy elements. Certain models of stellar evolution propose that high-mass black holes detected through gravitational waves originate from the collapse of massive stars deficient in heavy elements. The identification of Gaia BH3 represents the first observational confirmation of these theoretical frameworks. Now let's zoom out and take a look at our entire Milky Way galaxy. Interestingly, the Gaia BH3 system possesses another distinctive characteristic. Although it is currently situated close to the plane of our Milky Way, it actually belongs to the galactic halo and follows a retrograde galactic orbit, moving in the opposite direction compared to the majority of stars in the Milky Way, including our own Sun, which orbit within the galactic plane. Notably, it's a part of a group of stars in the galactic halo believed to have been accreted by our galaxy over 8 billion years ago. Finding Gaia BH3 is like the moment in the film The Matrix, where Neo starts to see the Matrix, remarked George Seabrook, a scientist at the Mullard Space Science Laboratory at University College London and a member of Gaia's Black Hole Task Force. In our case, The Matrix refers to our galaxy's population of dormant stellar black holes, which were hidden from us before Gaia detected them. Seabrook further emphasized that Gaia BH3 serves as a significant indication of this population, given its status as the most massive stellar black hole discovered within our galaxy. However, it's worth noting that Gaia BH3 pales in comparison to the supermassive black hole at the center of the Milky Way known as Sagittarius A. Sagittarius A boasts a mass 4.2 million times that of our Sun. Unlike stellar black holes formed from the deaths of massive stars, supermassive black holes like Sagittarius A result from a series of progressively larger black hole mergers. What do you find truly spectacular about black holes? Does the discovery of the Gaia BH3 black hole bring to mind any previous discoveries? Feel free to leave your answers in the comments below. Thanks for exploring with us. We'll see you next time on the channel.